respected Swami Paramahansananda, respected Tapunda, many other seniors present, I can see, Mr. Abhijit Dashgupta, Mr. Ashish Bose and friends. I will not stand between you in this movie. I have just come to see how they have finally managed to bring it out. That 150-year celebrations which followed one after the other, one for Vivekananda and the other for Vivekananda, were indeed high water marks in our in the Ministry of Culture. The 100 celebrations, records say, were also done on a substantial scale. But most of it came after the centenary. In other words, for the Tagore centenary, I remember, because Humayun Kobi was then Secretary of Culture, just a matter of how far the post has been degraded. And Humayun Kobi ji started what is called the Rabindra Rangamancha, Rabindra Shagam. He could not live to see a single one of them succeed. He died within the next year. But the scheme of Rabindra Shagam, Rabindra Bhavan continued for the next 20-25 years. In this case, government is not in that prosperous mode. So they insisted that everything should be done within 2 years. In fact, I'm sure Abhijit Babu and PSBT must have given some certificate that it's all over. Otherwise, they would have taken the money back from them. If I know my government, I've suffered for about 40 years now. Now, coming to this particular venture, PSBT selection was the Public Service Broadcasting Trust. Its selection on the very high level committee of headed by the Prime Minister, the then Finance Minister Pranab Babu, many eminent ministers, was one of the most peaceful agenda items I had. The Tagore and Vivekananda tend to evoke a lot of emotions, so my job was to set the ball rolling and then take records. And if I felt that an item would be short, then like every board member, we do a bit of backroom canvassing. In the case of PSBT, if you remember, the moment the name came up, everybody said yes. So we expect the standard to be very high. Then I was told that Abhijit Babu has used Yatra as a medium, so that would make it a more interesting presentation. But there are only two small things about Vivekananda Centenary that I would recall with fondness. I got a letter a few days ago from the University of Chicago, thanking us profusely for the contribution. Now, the story goes that when we went to Chicago about 2 years before the celebration, Prabhu asked me to have a look at the site, provided I could find it. So the site was located in what is called the Art Institute of Chicago. That particular building is now used by the Art Institute of Chicago. And when I asked people, they were not very particular as to where exactly it is. This strange priest come and say something. But it was not part of the discourse. So I walked around and then I found an old curator who said there's a green board there. Went up and found a little green tablet written that the holy monk of India had come here. The Ramakrishna Mission has a Vedanta ashram there, so we had a discussion, okay, how do we commemorate this place? The answer we got was flat no. No means no. The reasons were two. Number one, with that little green board, Indians, whenever they look at it, start prostrating. So rest of the visitors have to go over their bodies. When they see that little green board, this is the site of Swamiji's Chicago address, they start prostrating. So they found it quite a nuisance. Number two, and America does not believe in deification, making anybody God. Indians do. I saw a sheep a few days ago called High Rodeshwar on the high road. So you have one for every occasion. So our problem was how do we get it done? For instance, the external affairs minister Chinna, what I allowed him. And he repeated exactly the same thing. I'm amazed at the man's memory. Dora, they don't allow people to make us gods. There is nothing in the earth which is not immune from breaking. This is exactly the time that the University of Chicago and the Art Institute of Chicago were contesting for the legacy, and both had come up. I mean, they were not unduly bothered about Vivekananda, but they were proud of him. Both had approached the government of India for some assistance. So we made it a cause that Art Institute of Chicago, we bargained with them. They stopped at, they asked for nothing less than $1 million. I remember. Chicago University took $1.5 million, which is about eight and a half crores now. But with that, they have ensured that every year there will be a scholar for every 2 years, an internationally renowned scholar, Bhaktana Spoman, people of that stature, who will be known as Swami Vivekananda scholar of Indian culture. As long as man is alive, they have made a promise. As long as the university is alive, they shall honor him at Chicago. It is known as the Chicago Swami Vivekananda Chair. So at least, even if you spend 8 crores, it is worth much more than the amount of infructuous expenditure that we keep doing all the time around it. But then the university, the Art Institute of Chicago came up and said that where is our part of the deal? I can't tell you the amount, but we had a deal with them. They are coming to India and training us on art history. But that other part of the deal was they give us a place where you can put a proper plaque. So again I got a letter from them saying your plaque is out there, but the nuisance that we had feared has increased. Now that people know where Swamiji delivered his lecture, we have to actually take our turn around that spot because you can't travel. Indians now know very proudly, now you know very, at the moment you enter the Art Institute, you know that is very well. And when you stand there, even for an agnostic like me, you feel your hair getting up. So for those who are more respectful, those who are more devout, those who are stronger believers, I'm sure it's a very hallowed, sure it must be evoking stronger memories. And the urge to prostrate becomes very fast. So therefore visitors have to go over the bodies. This is one of the things. I'm sure Mr. Abhijit Dashgupta had to go to. This is the first of the films. I'm sure Rajiv Mehrotra and he and others must have done an excellent job. I just thought of narrating a small few anecdotes. With these words, I thank you all. Thank you very much.